Hello friends, welcome to Share Market Friend again. Today I am going to explain few basic things related to margins. If you are trading into stock market, if you are investing into stock market frequently, you must be knowing all this basic things related to margin. But in this document, which is published by NSE and BSE jointly, it is available on internet. Actually, it is kind of old, but it has good content. It is explained in the form of FAQ. So we'll try to explore few 4 to 5 important things related to margin. Actually, one of my viewer had asked me what is the difference between span margin and exposure margin. So if you want to see the basic formulas related to span margin, I have put it here. First thing that we need to consider for span margin is that it is based on PSR, that is worst possible moment for a stock in a day. So PSR is basically considered as 3 times standard deviation for index and 3.5 times standard deviation for stock, and we are considering this value for 2 days, and it is multiplied by square root of 2, that is 1.41, and that gives the span margin for that particular stock or index. And same way, there is a formula for exposure margin. So basically, this is just named differently and use different formula, but it refers to the margin only. So we need to understand how this need for margin arose, how this need for margin arises, where from it arises, and why it is required to have a margin, what it is basically. So you might be having understanding related to margin, so let's brush your understanding along with myself. Okay, so basically they are considering a simple example where one person is putting an order for buying a share of 1 lakh rupees, and one person who has that share, he is putting an offer for selling that share. So on second day, what happens, that share declines by 15,000 rupees and it reaches to 85,000. So it is simple thing that buyer won't buy it, he will refuse to buy it because he is getting the same share from open market at 85,000 rupees. So the seller faces a risk of failure of this contract or failure into his commitment. So to make it make this transaction serious and make this transaction execute irrespective of volatile moment of the share price, we created a concept of margin which helps to satisfy the commitment of transaction. So even though that share declines by 15,000 and it reaches 85,000, we take around 15 to 20% margin. I'm giving for example, we take 15 to 20% margin from both the parties, and if there is a variation in the price and they refuse to further buy or sell that share, we adjust whatever the changes in the basic contract or basic share prices happen with that margin. So that margin is basically used for compensating any volatility or movement in the share on 1 or 2 day basis. There are various formulas which are created for calculating this. So this margin basically makes two parties serious about the transaction. So this is a basic thing about margin we need to understand. Actually, it all goes through exchanges, through brokers, and then terminals and all. So this process gets automated through the system, so we don't bother of keeping margin in the account or not. It automatically gets deducted from your amount, whatever you have in your brokerage or in your bank account. So people are unaware about the margin they are putting for any transaction, most of the people. So first we need to understand how much margin we need to pay or we need to deduct from a seller or buyer of a share. For that we need to understand the concept of volatility. Basically, there are various definitions, as this document says, for calculation of volatility. So simple thing is that volatility is different changes in the basic price of a share on particular day. Suppose on one day a particular share is 100 rupees, and on second day it is 102 rupees, and third day it is 103, and then next day it comes back to 100 rupees. So there is a variation of price of 0 rupees because it incremented to 102, then 103, and then it came back to 104. But there is a volatility of 1 rupees and then 1 rupees and then 3 rupees on third day. So that changes in price on closing price basis on per day. That is called as volatility. And as we consider it on the basis of history, so it is called as historical volatility. Okay, so his they have given a standard formula for calculation of historical volatility. You have to put all closing prices for last 1 month or 6 month, whichever period you want to calculate, then take natural logs of today's closing price to yesterday's closing price, and then use a standard deviation formula that is readily available in Excel. You can take standard deviation of all this natural logs of closing prices ratios of that for that particular stock. So basically standard deviation gives you the mean or average value of changes over a period of time. So it moves in a range of 0 to 5%. So a standard deviation mostly come in the range of 3.5 or 3 or something. So it is a little complex formula of basic idea I'm trying to give you. Okay, this is, they have given screenshot for how to calculate it. If you want that, I will make a different video on that. So as I explained earlier, there is a difference between price movement and volatility. Price movement can be anything, but volatility is taken as absolute movement compared to yesterday's price. So it is simple thing that higher volatility means higher price movements and lower volatility means lower price movements or stability in the share or stock price. Okay, and volatility is not linked to the direction of the stock price. Stock may go from 100 to 105, then in one day only it can come back to 100. So there is a volatility in this stock, but price movements is zero. So there is volatility is irrespective of the direction of the price movement. So it explains here that how volatility affect margin. You must be knowing that if there is a share, if there is a election result, then volatility in the market rises because people are uncertain what could happen, how it is going to affect policies, how it is going to affect future prospect of the business. So in that way, if higher the volatility, higher margins are required because there is a chance of higher movement in the stock. So that way it is. Basically here are three types of margins are given for particular cash segment. Cash means for basic stock trading, that is buying and selling of stock, taking delivery of stock. So for that, three types of margins are used. First, value at risk margin, second, extreme loss margin, third, market to market margin. Of these three, first two are most important or required more understanding. First is that VAR, that is value at risk. Value at risk, as the name suggests, is basically it is assumption that with 99% confidence or on the based on last 6 month or whatever period of time you are considering, what amount of percentage is at risk. Means with 99% confidence, can you say that 5% of capital is at risk? For suppose there are large cap companies, for them VAR margin would be lower because with guarantee we can say there won't be such a huge volatility that can affect the overall asset or overall worth of the share. For small cap, the VAR margin could be higher because in a single day a lot, with guarantee we can say that large movement can come into. So how VAR margin is calculated? So here is one formula for that. Square root of, with example they have given, in that based on T or T plus one day movement of a share, 94% of weightage is given to volatility on T1 day, and 6% weightage is given on T day returns. For considering both the returns, you can use this formula to calculate VAR margin. This is actually readily available on NSE website for most of the stocks. You can go to the stock data page and look at the bottom of that data, you will get the VIR margin for that particular stock. On the basis of VIR margin and impact cost, impact cost is basically, suppose someone is selling the stock for 100 rupees and offer is available, someone want to buy a particular stock for 100 rupees and offer is available for 102 and later it becomes 103. So that difference, the more that difference is, the higher the impact cost, that is like representing the inefficiency of the market. So based on that and tradability of the market, suppose the stock is trading for 80% of the day throughout the all the trading days in a year and impact cost is less than 1%, then it is classified in group 1. And for impact cost higher than 1% and 80% trading days tradability, it is put in group 2 and remaining all other in group 3. So based on group 1, group 2 and group 3, this 3.5 times volatility margin is used as a VAR margin for group 1 shares or 7.5%, and 3.5 times volatility of the security or 3 times volatility of index, and this, there is a simple formula for this for group 2 shares. So based on volatility and impact cost, they are classified in groups, and for particular group, particular volatility, VAR margin is restricted. Second is extreme loss margin. Extreme loss margin aims at covering the losses that could occur outside the coverage of VIR margin. So this is a important thing we need to understand, that there are few events that happen very rarely. They are apart from daily volatility based on demand and supply and quality of the company or its performance over a time period. So there are few events like election, like any kind of problem or different RBI policy, etc. That could also affect the bank. So in that case, extreme loss can occur. For that, extreme loss margin is taken as additionally apart from the VAR margin. So for the extreme loss margin for any stock is higher of 1.5 times the standard deviation of daily natural log returns of the stock price in last 6 months or 5% of the value of the position, whichever is higher. So it is fixed at beginning of every month by taking the price data on a rolling basis for the past 6 months. Example is given here. Third is market to market margin, how it is computed. It is a simple thing that on closing basis, suppose if you have bought a call for 100 rupees and at the end of the day it has reached 105 rupees, so it needs to, the cost of that price or that price call or put, whatever you have bought, it needs to be adjusted for that particular share also. This happens. So for that, the closing price adjustment on margin is done. Whatever margin is collected from you or deducted from the seller, that is changed as per the closing price change of the share. So it is a simple thing. Here is a formula for M2M profit or loss, and all this information is available at NSE website. This link, I think this is expired link and this had changed, maybe, I guess. Apart from, as I explained, all these margins for cash segment, now there are two margins, or mainly two margins for FNO segment, as I explained earlier all these formulas. So let's explain it in more. First is called as initial margin, that is span margin, and second is exposure margin. There is a software called Standard Portfolio Analysis of Risk. So many people don't know that SPAN refers to that name of that software. It is basically developed by Chicago Mercantile Exchange of America. So it is extensively used by many leading stock exchanges of the world. So less people know about this. So this SPAN margin is calculated with different formulas based on volatility in a day and volatility index and all those complex things. It computes it 6 times in a day, first at the start of the day, then at the end of the day, and 4 times during the market hours. So here's a formula for span margin. This actually is updated, and latest formula is nearby this. And for exposure margin, formula is this. So in the same way, span margin, exposure margin is also collected. It is kind of both are margin, but they are classified on the basis of risk considered. So they add up to around 10 to 15% or 7 to 8% of the total contract value. And then there are few simple basic premium and assignment margins are considered. Premium margin is basically when you are buying a call or put, whatever premium, whatever value of that premium you required to pay, that is called as premium margin or premium value. And Assignment margins collected on assignment from the sellers of the contract. Assignment is like most of shares now trading in FNO are liable for physical or cash settlement, stock settlements. So for that, that assignment margin is considered. That is basically deducted when the expiry is near, or it increases as the expiry nears or volatility increases. All other few basic things are explained. At the end of this document, they have given basic formulas and explain these things in more detail mathematically. First is volatility and then standard deviation. Here is the formula with example, and then impact cost is also explained. Actually, impact cost is important thing. It is explained with example also. It is mostly a difference of bid and ask spread. So more the difference it is, the more impact cost, the more inefficient the market it is. Okay, so I'll try to make one video on impact cost also, because it's very important concept, need to be understood. Okay, this was all about understanding margins. Okay, it has explained the margins required in cash trading and margins required for FNO trading. So as I explained you, I hope you must have understood. If you found the speed little faster, then you can reduce the speed of this video clicking on setting, click on the speed and select the lower values for the speed. You can hear this video with lower speed, or if you want to increase, you can increase with the in same manner. If you like it, you can click on like and share this video and click on subscribe and click on the name of Share Market Friend. Go to videos, there you will find so many other videos for your reference which I have made for you, and I'm sharing my understanding with you. Please refer my disclaimer below this video before taking any action based on this video. Thank you very much for listening, Share Market Friend.